Hi, and welcome to another moment with Mike and Lois.
Hi.
So last one for this week.
Yeah.
Really want to get this out there today that, you know, there are many injustices in life.
Mm-hmm.
And we all experience them. It's called life.
Yeah.
That's what it's like.
Mm-hmm.
And no one is exempt from injustice. Some will feel it's more their life story than others. But the fact is, everybody has injustice. And so, you know, every step of the way, there's going to be people that will think things about us that are unfair, say things about us that are untrue, and do things to us that are unkind.
Yeah.
And we have to understand that God is using all of those situations to develop our character, to build us into the people that he wants us to be.
Mm.
Because he knows our timeline.
Mm-hmm.
He knows where we've started. He knows where we'll end, and he knows everything in between.
Yes.
And so we don't need to panic that if someone has stepped in and injustice has basically happened, we then think, well, that's not fair.
Mm.
And now that person is really preventing my progress.
Mm.
This is why it's so important to know God.
Yeah.
Because when we've got God on our side, nothing can actually cause his plans and his purposes to basically be thwarted in any way.
Yeah.
Because he has a way of being able to get us out of those situations because he's not dependent on people.
Yeah.
If people were more powerful than God, we'd be in trouble.
Yeah.
But they're not. And so God is more powerful than people, and he can overcome those situations.
Yeah, we sang that on Sunday, didn't we? God is fighting for us.
Yeah.
You know, he's on our side. And I think we forget that sometimes. We think that we're fighting all alone, or that everything is fighting against us. God is fighting for us. And we may not see the battle that he's fighting, but he's way ahead of us. And so, you know, really, we don't have to worry about what's going on around us. We just need to concentrate on who is fighting for us.
Well, if you look at Joseph's timeline, it doesn't look good. He's moving from one place to another.
Mm.
None of this looks like the vision he had when he got in trouble.
Nothing like it.
And, you know, here he is in prison, and he gets favoured, and he basically interprets some dreams. So one of the things I said about that was that he had to overcome the whole situation of having in his mind, the last time I interpreted a dream, the last time I shared a dream, I got into trouble. I got thrown in a pit. I could have lost my life.
Mm.
He had to overcome that to trust God again.
Yeah.
And so he basically interprets these dreams, and he says to two guys who had got in trouble with Pharaoh, remember me.
Yeah.
And what did they do? Or what did one of them do? Forgot him completely. But because God has our timeline in his hands, at this later stage, when no one could interpret dreams, even though Pharaoh brought in the best in the land, this guy that had forgotten him for all these years suddenly remembers. Ah, I know who can do this. There's a guy called Joseph.
Isn't that amazing, though? You know, he had to wait such a long time to be vindicated.
Yeah.
And that's the thing, isn't it? It's hanging on in there because you will be vindicated. God will see to it that you are vindicated.
Yeah.
But you know, God will use others' failures to prompt your success.
Yeah. Exactly what he did there.
And that's exactly what he did there. Because when the cupbearer came in, everything turned around.
Yeah.
There was a suddenly. You didn't see that coming. But God does that. You think, oh, I didn't see that coming. No, that'll be God. Because enter somebody that you'd never even thought would be your saving grace.
Right.
Because God can use that.
Well, because you think, I've been forgotten. I've been neglected.
Yeah.
And actually, he had.
Yeah.
He'd been neglected. He'd been forgotten. But here's the thing. Only neglected and forgotten by man.
Mm-hmm.
Never neglected and forgotten by God.
Never.
And that's what we need to remember.
Yeah.
Because we can treat God like we treat people,
mm-hmm.
or we can view God in the way that people treat us.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, they forgot about us, they don't care about us, they'll walk all over us. God won't do that.
Never.
And so God's saying, well, we'll see. We'll see. Just leave it with me.
Yeah.
I'll be back to you.
Leave it with him.
Leave it with me, and I'll be back on your timeline, showing you. And the whole thing, you know, we've got to really pricey this into, compact this right into the small part now of being able to share all the details very, very quickly. But there was acceleration in this last part of his life.
Yeah.
And basically got promoted to Prime Minister. And then, and that was, you know, you think that would be the end of the story. He's been in prison, now he's in Prime Minister. Mm-hmm. Pit to palace, as we say. And he makes this amazing statement after a further 14 years, when there were 7 years of plenty, 7 years of lack. And God used 7 years of lack because his brothers and his father had to come to ask for his help. And what he'd done in the 7 years of plenty was to store up enough food and resources to be able to feed people and resource them, including those of his own family. And so they come to him, obviously eventually there's reconciliation, there's forgiveness, and he said this amazing statement: you intended to harm me, but God intended it all for good. All for
all
good.
All those years of feeling as if perhaps he'd been abandoned, and that would I ever see my brothers again? Will I ever see God fulfill the dream that I had when I was 17?
Right.
How many people are sitting on those dreams today, thinking, will I ever see this come to fruition? You've just got to hold on like Joseph did and allow God to do it his way. And you know, the thing about the 7 years of plenty and the 7 years of lack, you know, Joseph was very astute. He was very wise in that time.
Yeah.
And it was because of his wisdom in keeping the grain and, you know, storing it all up, that it enabled then for his family to come to him because they also, they needed the grain.
Right.
Well, we've got to use wisely the time where we don't see our dreams come to fruition. Use that time wisely, because God's going to use that time right now for a later date to bring around that our breakthrough.
Absolutely. There's so much more I could share, and I'm sure there is. You.
Amazing story.
But there we go. We've run out of time today, and because our timeline's ticking.
Yeah, I think we're
so we just got off here. Anyway, so we'll be back again next Tuesday with some more moments. If you're able to be at Destiny on Sunday at 11 o'clock, we'll be sharing more of this story. In fact, we're going into a new story, but there's another timeline coming. So if you enjoy the graphics this week, they're going to be a repeated graphic next week with a new story, new timeline, new character. And it's all very relevant to our lives.
Yeah.
Whatever you're doing over the weekend, have a great weekend.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.